Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Shubhangi. I'm getting a lot of requests from you all to paint a coffee mug. So I thought let's do it today. So I have made this small design of dot mandala art on coffee mug. I have used Shunya's toolkit for this. Since I have used folk art multi-surface paint for painting on the ceramic surface, you can get this paint easily from Amazon. Friends, I have painted this mug around 2 years back and I have been using it since then and it's doing absolutely fine. I've used the same paint on it. So I am using this mug. I bought this mug from Amazon. So first you have to clean it completely to just wipe off any handprint, and these are the tools that I'm gonna use. So at first you have to stabilize your mug first. So I'm just putting this paint bottle and making it stable so that it will not move. Now I'm using a few shades of folk art multi-surface paint. So friends, at first I want to tell you the fact that you can't use your regular acrylic paint here. You have to have either ceramic paint or folk art multi-surface paint or any other multi-surface paint that is available near your place. So friends, at first you have to check the center of the mug. So you can either use a stencil or just a scale. I am doing it freehand. So at first I'm making a big round dot using the bigger dotting tool, bamboo tool, and then I'm using the fine dotting tool and making a cross shape structure, and then I'm filling up the space between them. So this is how I'm doing it. You have to use the finest dotting tool that you have. Friends, many people ask me why can't we use Fevicryl acrylic paint on the ceramic mug. So I have done that before because I was not very aware about the ceramic mugs. So what I did, I tried with Fevicryl acrylic paint, and when it get dried, it peeled off completely. Believe me, my whole design got peeled off completely. So then later on, after a lot of research, I found out that you have to get a multi-surface paint for painting on a mug or any ceramic plate, bowl, anything like that. So after completing my first row of white color, I am continuing with the same dotting tool with teal blue color. So you have to make dots in between the two dots of the previous row. And then similarly, I am dipping my tool into the yellow ochre color, and then I am making the dots slightly bigger as compared to the dots of the previous row, and I am making dots in between the two dots of the previous row. So you have to dip each time, or you have to take a little more paint if you want to dip it just once and make 2-3 dots. So in that case you have to take a little more paint. So similarly, I am continuing the fourth row using this pink color, bright pink color. So these colors are all available in folk art paint. So this is this shade is magenta pink color. So it looks really good. So I'm just using these four shades now, and then I am doing the bigger four dots using the bamboo tool, and I'm making a cross shape structure. So friends, if you are planning to do the top dots, I would suggest you to flatten this spikes that comes out of the paint. You can use a fine dotting tool and you can just spread all the extra paint that is there on the top and the center of this bigger dot. It happens with folk art paint every time. So as you can see, now I'm continuing it with white color or any cream color or white color, that whatever paint you have. So I am making a petal shape structure through this. I'm using fine dotting tool for making this petal shape structure. So I'm dipping my paint once, and then from the outer edge of the dot, I am just running the dots so that the size of the dots goes on decreasing, and it gives a beautiful petal shape structure. So friends, now I'm continuing and doing the same thing with the magenta color, and I am dipping my tool into the paint and then running my tool from outer edge of the dot, bigger dot, to the bottom of it, and it will give a beautiful petal shape structure. So similarly, I'm using yellow ochre color, and now here I'm using a slightly bigger dotting tool and dipping my tool into the paint, and from starting up from the outer edge of the bigger dot, and then moving towards the bottom of it, and making a petal shape structure. As the surface is beautiful, smooth, so it becomes very easy to start or to continue any design. So after this yellow ochre color, I am continuing the same pattern and using teal blue color. So you can see that I'm making a slightly bigger dots, and as compared to the dots of the previous rows. So you have to use a slightly bigger dotting tool for that, and dip your tool once, and then start with the outer edge and move towards the inner part of the dot. So you can see how this is looking, and I think it's looking fabulous. So there is a slight gap in between the petals where I am making the bigger magenta pink color, bigger dots using the bamboo tool, and then I am making this again. I am proceeding with the same petal shape structure using white color. So I'm dipping my tool into the paint and starting with the outer edge of the dot and continuing to the bottom of the bigger dot. So friends, I found there is a small gap at the base of the magenta color. So I thought of filling it up with the white color. So I'm dipping my tool into the paint and making two dots below them. And then I am proceeding towards the petal of this row. And I am using teal blue color and making the same petal shape structure, dipping my tool into the paint and then starting up with the outer edge of the dots, bigger bamboo dots, and then proceeding it towards its base. It's a very, very basic mandala design, but it looks absolutely beautiful whenever I make it, and I think you should definitely try it. So next row, I'm using this magenta color. So friends, for the next row, I'm again using yellow ochre color. So I'm dipping my tool into the paint and then making petal shape structure, starting off with the outer edge of the dot to the bottom of it. So I am now making a white color layer on this inner petal that I did before, because I thought it will give a beautiful dimension to it. So in the similar way as we have done before, I'm dipping my tool into the paint and then starting at the edge of the dot towards the base. So the inner mandala flower is almost ready. So I thought of making some swirls over it, but then later on I found that it's not looking that good, so I thought of just erasing it. So you can just use a tissue paper as I'm doing it here, or you can also use a earbud or a cotton swab. So friends, then I thought of making a small border on the mug. I wanted to keep it really simple. I don't want to make a very fancy and you know, like a very complicated design. Wanted to keep it simple and elegant. So I am now using this yellow ochre color and just making some rows of dots using my smaller size of bamboo tool. So I'm just dipping it once and making the dot, as you can see. And now I am just dipping my fine dotting tool and making some tiny white colored dots between these dots. So it will give a beautiful finish, you know, design to it. So you do, it's a very simple thing. You don't have to think much about it. You just have to dip your tool and then make tiny dots with that. So friends, you can also check how I am holding my mug. I have literally inserted my hand into the mug and it becomes very easy to, you know, rotate it slowly, and because it becomes very difficult for me to work on a you know, convex surface, slightly curved surface like a bottle or a mug. So I literally do this by inserting my hand into it as I'm doing it now. So friends, you just have to make the borders on upper and the lower part of the mug and using yellow ochre color, and then making the fine dots of white color. Friends, there are two techniques in which you can completely cure the paint. You can either air dry it for 21 days long. So after 21 days, the paint will completely be cured and you can use it for years, or you can wash it as well. And for the other technique, that is the baking, you have to allow the painted mug to dry completely for about 24 hours, and so that all the layers of the paint completely dry, and then you can place your mug into a cool oven, and you don't have to preheat the oven because in that case it will break. So you have to bake it for around 30 to 40 minutes. The temperature should be 350 degree Fahrenheit. So friends, now I am proceeding towards the design, and I thought of making some more dots between the petals, and I'm using magenta color, and then I am making two teal blue color just above it. So I think this design looks pretty good now. It was looking a little incomplete initially to me, then so I thought of doing it like this. Friends, I would say that if this mug is completely dry, still you can't completely scrub it like you do with your regular utensil. You have to be little gentle while washing it. I would suggest you to use your hand washing technique rather than washing it in the dishwasher. So I just hope you have enjoyed watching this video, and I enjoyed it too for making this video for you. If you're new to my channel, please do subscribe to my channel, and if you are already, you have already subscribed to it, please hit the like button and give your comments. Let me know what else you want to see in this video. Thanks a lot. Have a nice day. Bye bye.